You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, July 13th, 2021. Yesterday, we started our look at the second of the Beatitudes. We are looking at the Beatitudes from the Gospel of Matthew in chapter 5. And the second Beatitude is this: blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Yesterday, we explored how Jesus sees our pain and how in order to be happy, we need to turn to Him for comfort. Not think we're going to get it from other people or from distractions or that we're going to be able to fix ourselves, but that we will only be happy if our comfort comes from Christ. Now, there are several other important lessons that we can pull out of this beatitude. And today we are going to talk about the important call to repentance. Now, repentance is a big word, but it's something that we experience from the time we are very little. Repentance is when we have done something bad or even gotten into a bad habit. We realize that it is wrong. We ask for forgiveness, and we decide to live differently and to start again. That is repentance, to repent for our past sins. But something that is important that Christ points out here is that we should be quite sad, even to the point of crying, when we think about the ways that we have sinned against Jesus. And in fact, being sad about our sins is important. Christ is saying, blessed are those who mourn, who look back on the sins that they have committed and that they feel sadness. Now, if you do something nasty and you don't feel bad about it at all, you only apologize because you know you have to, well, that's not true repentance. True repentance demands that we feel sorry, that we're almost sick to our stomach. We can't believe that we did the things that we did. Now think for a second about something that you did that was wrong. Whatever it might be, maybe you were mean to someone, maybe you took something that didn't belong to you, maybe you deliberately said something that wasn't true. Whatever it was, we're all sinners. But think about maybe you got caught doing that thing and you had to come clean and admit that you had done something wrong. Have you ever experienced, well, as you are admitting it, you cry? Now, maybe you felt silly or weak, but I want you to know that those tears were a good thing. You were living out this beatitude. Also, oftentimes people cry when they go into the sacrament of confession. Have you ever noticed that there's a big box of tissues in there? That's because when we are confronting the sins that we have committed, we should feel sad. Now, what's so beautiful is that church fathers have often talked about how the tears we cry when we are repenting for our sins are like a second baptism. The tears wash away our guilt. So never be ashamed of crying in the confessional. Never be ashamed of crying when you confess to a sin that you have done. Know that Jesus is already there, so proud of you for being honest and making a new start. He is offering you His comfort as you do that. And so, Sprouts, let's reflect on this Bible verse from Matthew chapter 5, verse 4 about the second beatitude. And as we do this, let's contemplate the sins that we have yet to confess, have yet to repent for, and let's make a resolution to do that. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Just one more thing. If you are looking for a good boredom buster or preschool prep for the fall, we have put together the ABCs of the Catholic Faith coloring pages. It is a downloadable set that is 100% free. You can find the direct link to download this set and use them right away in the notes for this podcast episode.
This show is a production of the Spoke Street Media Podcast Network. For more great podcasts, visit SpokeStreet.com.